Okay, YouTube, so I've got this Toyota Tarago that I've got to paint this afternoon. It's got a bonnet there. I had to do the seam seal of beads up under there. I've got the bump bar there. I'm waiting on one of these tow hooks because they sent the tow hook covers, because they sent the wrong one out. I've already waxed and grease removed the rest of the job. I've got this one, this part here too. That's just a bumper reinforcement. And yeah, got the guard to do. I'm going to do a little bit of masking there actually. And yeah, I think that is actually a black plastic strip, like a decal, a vinyl strip. They're going to have to put it on the bonnet if they decide not to. I'll just have to paint that black to meet up. So yeah, plastic anti-static cleaner over the bar. Bit of wet on wet. If I have enough, I'll whack a bit over that guard, but I only mix up 320 mils. Like, I always try to keep my paint mixing to a minimum and waste as little as I can. OC2K top coat, so that's just hardening with the colour. I'll take this out while I'm mixing it up too. Where the GoPro on the way out there too. The go patient. God damn it. I left the anti-static cleaner out there. Go for a walk. Hate that. So I'm gonna get a bit of fine line tape for that guard too. There's my anti-static cleaner. So it's actually a pretty nice day today. I think they said it was like 28. Nice and warm. It's a touch humid. You might have noticed the clouds outside. Perth doesn't usually get too humid, but this year's been a bit of a funny year for the weather. Like, we haven't had those real stinking hot days that we used to get. Kind of been real up and down, like a bit of humidity and stuff like that. Honestly, humidity is probably the worst weather to work in. Like, 30 degrees feels like 40. Like, I'd probably rather a 40 degree dry heat day than 30 degrees with humidity, high humidity. This is a lot harder with gloves on. And like, this has all been done before, this job. This guard was actually already the wrong colour, so I just checked my colour to the door, and what I do here is actually going to be an improvement on what they've got on there already, so it's always a good thing. Any of you guys get into the share market? I've been dabbling a little bit in the Australian share market. Leave a comment down below if you got any good stock picks for us. But today we took a big hit. Luckily I didn't have too much money in there and I didn't lose too much, but like, the American stock market's had its biggest downturn in quite a while today. Today being the 5th of February, by the time this actually gets up on YouTube, who knows what the day will be. My internet speed over here in Perth, or in the suburb I'm living in, is an absolute joke. I'm gonna have to move out. Like, when this lease runs out on this home, I'm out and I'm moving into a place that's got good internet. I don't care if I have to pay an extra 150 or 200 bucks a week. I need good internet to upload videos. That's my plan at this point, is to stockpile heaps of footage. I'm gonna go and see if I can find this new computer tonight, like a second-hand one. It looks killer. It's gonna be like $2,000 worth of computer, but yeah, if it was all to buy a brand new, probably looking at $6,000. Anyway, I'll stop talking shit. I'll get to it. Oh, actually, no, I can keep talking for a bit. I'll wipe this down with the anti-static cleaner. Yeah, so this computer I'm going to get, it looks like an absolute beast. 6 gigabyte graphic card. It's like a i7. What is it? A 6-core, 12 thread, or something like that? CPU. Yeah, just a bit of a beast. I want to get it down to like 1800 or something. It's advertised for 2300, but I just can't justify that much at this point in time. And then what I might do is give my old computer a bit of a refurb and see if I can sell that for 500 and make some of my money back, and then sort of look at it as like a big upgrade for like $1,300. I can't be bothered buying, like just giving my computer an upgrade, because to get the Ryzen CPU, I need a new motherboard, and then to get a new motherboard, you know, you're going to have to get other things, and RAM, that's the one, because I need DDR4 RAM for the new motherboards, and then it just sort of just adds up, and then you're stuck with all these old computer parts and that, so just do a full upgrade, and see if I can pass the old one on after giving it clean up and format. Custom painted, it does look pretty cool. Alrighty. Let's go. Flash the primer first up. And wet on wet, and then I'll go out, mix up my my colour.
winter. Try and get that stuff covered down there. Now that will be covered by a bonnet belt, so she'll be freaking hot, mate.
So I don't even know if you guys could hear me when I was talking a bit of crap there, but I was trying to get that paint inside there and yeah, she started running. But there is a big bonnet felt that's going to sit up under there, and that will just cover that, so that's perfect. I don't even care about that run. It's not worth my time and effort trying to fix it. So I think I might actually switch this camera off while I do go out and mix up that colour, because it's starting to overheat. As I said, it is a hot day, and this camera does usually after about 20 minutes, and it's up to 16 minutes, so I might be able to just mix the colour up, but then when I get back in, I'll get halfway through painting and it'll shut down. So I'll give it a few minutes to cool down. I'll take the guns out, I'll give that a quick wash out, and I might use it again for colour. It was doing pretty well, the ANI F150 1.3. Alright, so got that 2K colour, VOC mixed up in the gun, ready to go. Gave that, well, it's probably been about 5 minutes by the time I went out and came back in, mixed it up, 5 to 10 minutes. That's perfect, flash off time in this kind of weather. Yeah, I decided to change the regulator out, or the cheater valve, whatever you want to call it, because I like to know where I'm at with my pressures. Anyway, long show's going to be enough for the inside, so it's going over a very light colour to put on the primer. that's us. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I'm going to go out, clean that gun out, and by that time I'll be pretty safe to come back and hit base. Weave through there without hitting that yard. So yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Until then, get out there and find some shit. The old FPS, ANI F100, sorry, HPS, not FPS, does okay, really. Like, you can't fault that finish. Whites are actually a real prick to see going on. You don't get as much reflection as what you do in the dark colours. Oh yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. All good.